Hello everyone, my name is Jakob Lundholm. I'm product manager in Danfoss Industrial Refrigeration, and I'm here today to tell you about our new liquid level switch, the LLS 4000. The LLS 4000 can be used for high level protection of compressors or low level protection of your refrigerant pumps. The product is, beside being electronic, also configured with an app. It's a very compact unit consisting of a mechanical part, electronic part. The mechanical part has a pressure rating of currently 65 bar, soon actually up to 140 bars. The two threads, we have two thread types. We have a G thread pipe thread and a NPT thread, both of them in 3/4 inch. The electronic part has a SIL 2 or SIL design, can be purchased with a SIL 2 certificate, and with that you are actually complying with EN378. You power it up by 24 volts DC and via this M12 cable. But let's look a bit on how it actually works or operates. In this liquid column here, we have a pump being controlled by the two devices, so meaning that it cuts whenever it reaches the high point and starts again when it reaches the low point. As you can see, you have two LEDs on the product here, one green indicating when you have power on the unit, and one orange which tells you when there's liquid in front of the product. The technology we are using is called is microwave, and different from capacitive technologies, it works more precise and it works much faster. It works, or when you have microwaves, you get a signal back with a resonance, and depending on the media in front of the LLS, it will then consider it to be, let's say, ammonia or freon. It also means that if you have like a substance like foam on top of it, it will not be considered as liquid because it has not the right resonance frequency. So the product is actually able to disregard what we are looking for and what we are not looking for. So, but let's talk a bit on what it means with SIL. SIL means safety integrity level. It's with this product you get a SIL design having redundancy on the electronic part. It means you have two microprocessors and you have two relays. Because what you want when you want to control and protect your compressors or pumps is a high level of reliability, and with two circuits here we can use that for different purposes. One of them is what is called the voting principle. It means that you have actually two calculations of whatever is measured here that is being compared, and only if the two are equal, it's considered as a safe measurement. We also use, we also have autodiagnostics inside of the product, meaning that we are monitoring the health of the product, we are monitoring the hardware components, and we are also monitoring exterior things like temperature being out of, you could say, the range, low or high, but also, let's say, the power is only 10 volts compared to the 24 volts. All this is monitored, and before, you could say, you have a problem in your system, the product will show you with a red LED on the end here, and it will go into safe state. And that is the essence of a reliable product, that whatever happens, it brings you home. It brings you to a safe state, and let's say we have with a high level, that would mean that we would have liquid detected, that the pump is stopping, like this, and the system would basically stop. So, the product is app configured, and I will show you a bit on how that works. It's the Danfoss app. You can download it from the App Store and also Google Play. It works in the way that you scan for the products. It's based on or works with Bluetooth. And in this case, we have in our proximity two devices. We have a maximum level and we have a minimum level. I will now connect to the upper one, the maximum level. As you can see in a second, it starts flashing, indicating I'm the one you're connected to, whereas the other one is still green. Inside the app, you can configure media type and also the switch state. With the media type, you tell the product what to look for and what not to look for. Currently, it's available for ammonia and also a number of freon types. Soon, we will add more to it. The switch state indicates whether you should open the relay or close the relay whenever you have liquid in front of the product. I will now show you a bit on what we also can do, entering our service mode. We are now in service mode, and inside here, that is actually where you can change the configurations, but you can also do what we call a relay switch test. So let's say we want to test or open the relay up here. I immediately stop the pump. I can exit the test and we will start all over again. I will now open the relay and I stop the pump. So in this way, you can actually check if whatever you are controlling with these devices is actually working, even without having refrigerant in your system. Then you may ask, how can we do a product for the industrial segment based on Bluetooth technology? You know, everyone has mobile devices. So what is the safety in this? Very relevant question, we get it often. There are many reasons for this being a safe system still. You have to be in proximity. When you use your device, you have to be in a proximity of around 10 meters if you're in a normal machine room. In addition, you would, at the first time you connect to any of the devices from a mobile device, you would have to enter a PIN code, just like when you are in your car and would like to link to your audio system the first time. And then, as you saw before, when you want to change configuration, you have to know a password. And obviously, all of them can be changed in the service view as well, both the PIN code and the password. And then also, if you buy the product with a SIL certificate, we have removed the possibility to change the relay state, switch the relay state, so you don't do anything by accident. And finally, with the app, we can also update the firmware and the product. So once we release the product for new refrigerants like CO2 or refrigerant oil, which is coming up, you can actually upgrade your product already and be ready to configure the product to that. So finally, a bit about our installation. There's a number of things to observe. Obviously, you would like to have a good free flow around your sensor. You don't want things to accumulate like dirt. You don't want gas to be stuck somewhere in here. And that's why we recommend a horizontal installation. In this way, you get no gas pockets and you don't get, or you have a free flow of liquid. To enhance this, we also have original weld connectors, which are different in the way from standard weld connectors that we have machined all material away here. So only part of the height here is with thread, meaning you have a good space here for a free flow of refrigerant. The product is IP66. So it has a very high ingress protection, meaning that it can resist both outdoor installation if that is required, but also the ice build that you may have from your low temperature systems. Then may you ask that with this rather short weld connector, which is favorizing correct detection of and free flow of liquid, how can we then insulate? That's also a very good question we often get. Of course, if we are in a machine room and you have a low temperature inside in the media, there's no problem in covering this part of the product also with insulation. So, all in all, we believe it's time to switch whatever we are, if we are talking about new installations or retrofitting your old system, then it's time to switch with this reliable product, which is has a sill design and a single point connection, very easy to install. As said before, it's currently available for ammonia and a number of freon types. And very soon we will have it available also for CO2, for refrigerant oils, and in addition, R1234ZE. And on top of that, we are also increasing the pressure rating to 140 bars. Thank you for watching this, and have a nice day.